Hi everyone. Today in this video, let us discuss a combination of insulin, glargine and lixisenatide. In this combination, two drugs are there. First one is insulin glargine, which is one of the long-acting basal insulin analog. So this is just like human insulin, which is modified by recombinant DNA technology and is a long-acting insulin preparation. Second component is the lixisenatide, which is one of the GLP-1 receptor agonist, glucagon-like peptide 1 receptor agonist. Both of these drugs can be combined in a single pen, available for subcutaneous injection, and this combination is well known with its brand name, Soliqua 100/33. This combination is specified by the strengths by which these two components are mixed. Here the strength 100 indicates 100 units of insulin glargine. Similarly, the 33 indicates 33 micrograms of lixisenatide. So both of these drugs are combined in a single pen for subcutaneous injection, and this combination can be given in the patients with type 2 diabetes mellitus. Generally in the diabetes, we can use single components like insulin glargine or lixisenatide as single drugs alone in the injection. These drugs can be given in the people who are unable to control glucose levels even with controlling the diet and proper exercise. So in such people with type 2 diabetes mellitus, either insulin glargine or lixisenatide can be given. But when these drugs are used alone up to 60 units, still they are not controlling blood glucose levels, then we can use this combination insulin glargine plus lixisenatide. So this combination can be combined in a single pen for subcutaneous injection, which can control the blood glucose levels in an efficient way compared with single drug preparations. But while we are using this combination, we have to take few of the precautions. Soliqua 100/33 should be carefully used and should not be used more than 60 units per day. So 60 units is the maximum dose of this combination. And this combination should not be combined with other GLP-1 agonists. We have different types of GLP-1 receptor agonists like semaglutide, liraglutide, dulaglutide. So many types of GLP-1 receptor agonists are available. But these GLP-1 receptor agonists should not be combined with this Soliqua, because Soliqua already contains GLP-1 agonist. Similarly, while using this injection, in order to prevent any allergic reactions at the site of injection, it is advised to rotate the injection sites with each time of injection. Similarly, Soliqua should be carefully given few of the people. In the people with low blood glucose levels, Soliqua should not be given because it further reduces the glucose levels. So in the diabetic people who are having hypoglycemic phase, Soliqua should not be administered. Similarly, in the people with any history of pancreatitis, this Soliqua should be carefully given. Similarly, in the people with stones in the gallbladder, again, this injection should be carefully given. With these precautions, Soliqua can be given in the people to control diabetes who are unable to control their blood glucose levels with single drug administration. So today in this video, we are going to see how this combination acts, what are the important precautions, how they should be managed, what are the important side effects, doses, all these things we will discuss in this video. First of all, let us see how this combination acts. One of the components in this combination is the insulin glargine. This is just like the human insulin, but it is somewhat long acting. And this component acts just like insulin, thereby it can increase the glucose uptake, particularly into the muscle and fatty tissues. Similarly, it inhibits the hepatic glucose production, thereby it can reduce blood glucose levels. Third type of action is on the lipolysis. It can reduce the lipolysis and proteolysis. Even it can increase the protein synthesis by which glucose is more utilized, so that the blood glucose levels are reduced. By all these three actions, insulin glargine can reduce the glucose levels in the blood. Another component is the lixisenatide. This component is a GLP-1 receptor agonist. Its primary action is on the pancreas, where it is going to increase the release of insulin. Similarly, it can produce some delay in the gastric emptying, which reduces glucose absorption. And finally, this drug can also reduce the appetite, which reduces the food intake, thereby glucose levels can be controlled. In this way, insulin, glargine and lixisenatide better control glucose levels. This is a beta cell. On the beta cell, GLP-1 receptors are expressed. These are G protein coupled receptors coupled with alpha, beta, gamma subunits. Now, lixisenatide can act on GLP-1 receptor as agonist, which activates adenylyl cyclase system. This adenylyl cyclase can convert the ATP into one of the secondary messenger, cyclic AMP. This cyclic AMP can increase the levels of protein kinase A. Now, when this protein kinase A levels are elevated, it increases the calcium entry. So, because of more entry into the calcium, the beta cell is depolarized, which results in the release of insulin from the cell. In this way, lixisenatide can increase the insulin secretion. This insulin can add to the action of insulin glargine, which is externally given. So, lixisenatide can promote the action of insulin glargine by increasing the insulin secretion. Now, let us see the precautions of this combination. Insulin glargine plus lixisenatide should be carefully given because each drug is having its own precautions. Many of the antidiabetics can affect the pancreas. Among them, lixisenatide is a GLP-1 receptor agonist. It can act on the pancreas to produce some inflammation, so it can produce pancreatitis. So, patients having previous history of pancreatitis, this combination should be carefully given. And any development of severe abdominal pain, nausea and vomiting may indicate the development of pancreatitis. Then careful monitoring is required because GLP-1 receptors are associated with risk of pancreatitis. For this reason, other GLP-1 receptor agonists should not be combined with this combination. Similarly, another precaution is that this combination, when it is used in the type 2 diabetes, it can have two effects. When this combination is not working properly, it can increase the glucose levels, resulting in hyperglycemia. But most of the times, when the dosage is properly administered, they can work better to control the blood glucose levels, and sometimes their action may be increased by other agents. In such situations, this combination can produce hypoglycemia. Hypoglycemia is one of the important side effects with many of the antidiabetic agents and insulin preparations. When this hypoglycemia is going to be developed, very fatal symptoms can be observed. It can produce severe headache, dizziness, weakness, fast heartbeats, and even a confusion, fatigue. All these symptoms can be produced with severe hypoglycemia. So care should be taken to avoid the development of hypoglycemia because this combination works very better to control blood glucose levels. So while using this combination, it is better to control other antidiabetic agents. Their dosage should be reduced. Otherwise, it may lead to severe hypoglycemia. Another important precaution is that this combination can develop some acute kidney failure. This effect can also be observed with lixisenatide. So in such people, we can observe diarrhea, nausea and vomiting, along with some dehydration. If these symptoms are observed, it may indicate some kidney failure, which is acute in nature, shortly developed. So whenever this combination is withdrawn, the kidney failure can be restored. So in those people with any previous history of kidney failure or risk for developing of acute kidney failure, this combination should be carefully used. Another important precaution commonly observed with many of the insulin preparations is the development of hypersensitivity in the people. Some allergic reactions can be produced with insulin preparations. Even this risk is somewhat less pronounced nowadays, but still hypersensitivity may be observed in few of the people. So if you observe any allergic conditions like facial swelling, swelling of tongue, lips, fainting, and some dizziness and trouble in breathing, all these may indicate hypersensitivity that may be developed towards insulin preparations. Finally, this combination can also reduce the potassium level, so low potassium can be observed with this combination. So in such people, we can observe few of the symptoms like respiratory paralysis and cardiac arrhythmias. But when this combination is properly used, we can avoid the development of hypokalemia. Another important precaution is the gallbladder problems that can be observed with this combination. So in such people, we can observe severe abdominal pain, development of fever, and development of jaundice resulting in the yellowish skin and eyes. If patients are having these symptoms, it may indicate the problem with gallbladder. In such people, this combination should be avoided as it further increases the risk of gallbladder stones. Now let us see the side effects of this combination. The important side effects are mainly related with gastrointestinal system. So this combination can produce diarrhea, headache, nausea and vomiting. It can produce some hypoglycemia resulting in the weakness, and even it can produce some rhinitis, cold-like symptoms, upper respiratory tract infections which may lead to trouble in breathing and coughing. How it is given? This combination is available as a subcutaneous injection, as a pen. It is well known under brand name Soliqua 100x33. So this contains two components, as we have discussed earlier. First one is the insulin glargine and second one is lixisenatide. Here insulin glargine is available as 100 units and lixisenatide is available as 33 micrograms. So what this indicates? That means one unit of this injection contains 100 units of insulin glargine and 33 micrograms of lixisenatide. That means if you want to take 30 units of Soliqua 100x33 injection, then this 30 units contains 30 units of insulin glargine and 10 micrograms of lixisenatide. Now if you see the dose can be started at lowest dose starting from 15 units of Soliqua 100x33, and this dose should be given within 1 hour before the first meal of the day. And the dose can also be increased to 30 units in order to better control glucose levels. And based on the efficacy, the dose can be increased up to 60 units. That is a maximum dose that can be used with the Soliqua per day. So that's all about this combination Soliqua, which contains insulin glargine plus lixisenatide. Insulin glargine is a human insulin, which is a long-acting insulin preparation. Whereas lixisenatide is a GLP-1 receptor agonist, which can increase the insulin secretion as well as it can control the appetite, thereby it can control blood glucose levels. But this combination should be carefully given in the people with any history of pancreatitis and gallbladder problems. So that's all about this combination Soliqua. Hope this video is useful to you. If you really like this video, please subscribe to our channel. Share this video with your friends. Post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.